What's going on, guys? Today we're tuning in this 2004 Ford Mustang Mach 1, which is kind of cool. These things, factory shaker hood scoop deal. It's a 4.6 liter four valve engine out of the box. That's how they come. This one has some ported heads, set of camshafts. It's 11 2-to-1 compression, but still naturally aspirated on E85. This one actually has a Haltech ECU in it. So this is an Arizona car up here in Michigan. I see a lot of these, but man, do I never see them that are this nice. This thing is like, it's flawless. If I had an opportunity to put it on a hoist and take a picture of the underside of it, I would do that for you guys, but unfortunately that's not gonna happen. So anyway, see what this thing's gonna make to the tire here. I got a bunch of drivability stuff to sort out. It is a stick shift car still. But gonna see what we can make with this thing and go from there. So here's what the curve looks like. The numbers, it made 348 to the tire horsepower, 278 foot-pounds of torque. See the graph's a little oddball down here in the beginning. I moved ignition timing around and fuel targets around to try to clean that up, and nothing seemed to make much of a difference. So I'm kind of thinking that that's a camshaft and intake manifold, just an issue there, an airflow issue there. So he's actually planning on putting a shorter runner intake manifold on it. Currently, this is a stock intake manifold, unported. He's got somebody making him a 10-inch runner piece, which will much better suit this camshaft setup. But it did make peak power all the way out at like 7,200, 7,300. So it's good power up top. It just lacks a little bit of torque down low. I don't know. I would be unlikely that the intake manifold is going to help that. It's probably going to hurt it, but hopefully then we can turn it a little bit more RPM. It's definitely going to be worth some horsepower though. So we'll see what happens when it comes back. But for now, that's that. I don't know what these things make stock. For reference, a stock 2-valve 4.6, not a 4-valve, so totally different engine, but same displacement. They make about 220 at the tire out of the box. These things, I know this engine here was rated, I believe, somewhere in the mid-300s flywheel from the factory. So if it was 350 flywheel from the factory at the tire, that would have been in the 270 range. So 350 the tire's not bad, but there's definitely more on the table with some tweaks.